Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel ServerGyan. My name is Dr. Lokendra Singh and today we are going to discuss about httpd. It means Apache server. So what is Apache server? Let me tell you first of all. So Apache httpd is one of the most used web servers on the internet available today. Nginx is another, maybe Tomcat is also available, but for this video I'm going to discuss about Apache. So a web server is a daemon that speaks with HTTP or HTTPS protocol. But if you talk about HTTP, so HTTP is a text based protocol for sending and receiving objects over the internet connection. Now if you talk about HTTP protocol, so this send over the wire in clear text format, means all the data which is sent over the network, that is in clear text format. This uses port 80 with TCP protocol suite. And if you talk about HTTPS, so HTTP uses port number 443 by default. These can be modified. I will show how to modify that. And by default, HTTP uses GET method. GET method means whenever you hit any server, so you get all the data from server. So that is known as GET request. So within this video guys, I'm going to let you know that what all options are available and what are basic parameters of this Apache. So let us start with. So first of all, I will have to install package yum install httpd-y. So this will install all the packages which are required because I'm using RHEL 7. So all the required packages will be installed here. Within last video, I just demonstrated like how to enable Apache server, but not only installing package is good enough. You will have to understand what all directives are there, what all configuration options are available. So you should have understanding for that particular stuff. Reason being, once you have started configuring Apache server, so you should be able to troubleshoot as well. If in case there is a problem, or the server is not coming up, so first of all you should have hands-on practice, or you should have basic understanding like how to start troubleshooting and what are the steps, like where you can go and check and try to fix, and later on obviously you will fix the issue, but you should understand that where can the problem exactly be. So for now I have installed package, so let me go inside the configuration file. So etc httpd and http.conf conf/httpd.conf. This is main configuration file of httpd service. So httpd is daemon for this, and this is configuration file which is vim's editor which I'm going to use, and etc httpd conf and http.conf is the file. Okay, so this is the main Apache HTTP server configuration file. As the content says, it contains the configuration directives that give server its instructions. It means currently we are working with Apache 2.4. So what are main directives within this configuration file? I'm going to explain. So first of all is server root. So let me search here, S-E-R-V-E-R-R-O-O-T, server root. Search here. And there will be one entry which will be uncommented. So etc httpd, this is basically server root where all the configuration file will be fine, or where you can configure rest of stuff. Okay, now listen means the particular port of Apache which will be listening to your request. For example, there is only port 80 allowed, but if you want, you can specify your server IP address as well. Maybe you can specify your private server if you are working with DMZ zone, it means demilitarized zone, so you can specify your public IP address. If you are working on intranet, it means you want only your private subnet to be allowed there, so you can specify your private IP address as well here. Okay, after that, if you want to talk about rest of files, so there is particular directive which is known as include. What does it mean? If you want to have multiple files, it means you want to have separate file for separate domains which you are going to host, or you want to have separate file for a separate requirement as per your company or as per your domain specification. So you can have several files included within this particular. So all the files which are inside conf.d, because obviously as we know etc httpd is like server root. So under that particular folder, so there will be conf.module.d file, and after that star.conf. So all the files which are ending with .conf extension. So these files will be read by your Apache server, or you can call it as HTTPD service. So whatever you write, so that will be considered as your configuration file. If there is any problem, so you will definitely get to know that the syntax error is there. Fine. Now next is, if you talk about, next is your user. User is there. Now what does user mean? User means who is owner of this particular service. So all the service will be running using Apache user, and group of the service will be Apache, because Apache is by default the service name. We are whether the daemon is HTTPD, but service will be Apache and the service user will be Apache. So HTTPD is daemon, but if we talk about like what you are configuring or what web server you are working with, so you will not say HTTPD, you will say Apache web server you are working with. Fine. Then after, one more directive is your server admin. What does it mean? Okay, so currently it is mentioned here root at the rate localhost. So if you want to modify, so you can give your email ID. If in case of any error occurs, so you will be notified over your email, and as and when required, you will be getting notifications depending on the configuration which you are going to do. Fine. After that, the directory location, directory is directory, directory, directory. What does it mean? So where you are going to keep your data, it means the particular location where you will be keeping your data. So what does it mean? Allow, override, none, require, all, denied. What does it mean? It means that this will, there is a particular configuration file which is known as .htaccess. Let me tell you, there is a configuration file which is known as .htaccess, which contains username and password for your website. For example, you have your private domain running and you have created some users who are allowed to log into your server. So there may be multiple directories. Maybe this is one, you can have second one, you can have third one and fourth one. So if you say allow, override, none, it means .htaccess file will not be read for per directory basis. It means you cannot have multiple .htaccess file if this is none. Reason being, if you configure this in such a fashion that this would be read by multiple folders, or you can call it like per directory basis you are going to configure. So setting to this option, performance penalty will be there, as well as security remediation you will have to face. It means this could cause your security, as well as you will have to face some security degradation issues. Reason being, as and when your service will require access, so every time multiple .htaccess file will be read and you will have to face some trouble related to that. Okay, require all denied. What does it mean, require all denied? It means whenever you are going to configure your server and you have set it to require all denied, it means HTTPD will refuse to serve content out of directory. So whatever directory you are going to set, it means directory slash. So slash, I will explain very soon. What does it mean? So all the content which will be out of the directory, returning, it will return one error message with 403, which is known as forbidden. So this request, or you can call it whenever any client will try to hit your server, so the client will get one error message as 403 forbidden, and request will be sent to client from server side. Okay. If this is set to require all granted, what does it mean? Over here where denied is written, so we can mention as granted as well. So what does that mean? Allow access to this directory, the directory which we are going to talk about, and setting this on a directory outside the normal content tree have security implication. It means if you set this to granted, so this will have some security implication on your web server. So ideally this is suggested that this should be require all denied. Basically you need to have all of your content which you are going to work with should be inside your directory defined. Whatever directory you define, So that should be available. Okay. One more thing is here, which is known as options. Let me show you options, options. What does it mean? Okay. So options means, okay, this is basically directory what we are talking about, where www HTML. It means if anything is found out of this, so that will be treated under that particular section. So where www HTML is our default context path. It means whatever we are going to serve for our web server or we are web server, so that has to be kept inside where www HTML folder. Okay, so what does option means? Options means indexes and follow same links. What does it mean? So first of all, options allow plus and minus. It means turn on and turn off feature is available here with index option. For example, if indexing options shows that directory listing, if a directory is requested and no index.html files in the directory, it means that if file does not exist but still you have enabled this option, so it will start requesting for some other options. So we will discuss later on in advanced section of this particular. Allow override none. We have already discussed this before. So this is for this particular section where www.html. So this is allowed here. Okay. Then if you talk about rest of detail, so there are multiple directories. Maybe you can search for logs. Let me write here logs logs. So you can search log, you can search here for. Okay, so error log will be kept here. It means logs slash error dot log. In the same fashion you will find access log as well, and you can use file module as well. Why file module, we will discuss very soon. So what does it mean? Okay, let me tell you right away, because as we are here on this file module. So if a block which is with file directory, it means files. So blocks works just as a directory block, but their option for individual wildcard file is used, as we see here .ht*.html, htm, htv, if there is any sort of syntax. So all the files we can mention here. And same here, the feature is required or denied. It means all the data out of this particular syntax will be denied under this particular file module. Okay, what else does it do? It means in this case, while we are talking about file system, file directory. So in this case, the block prevents HTTPD from serving out of any security sensitive file like .htaccess or .htpasswd. There are two files. One is .htaccess, it means where user's information is kept, and second file is .htpasswd, where password of all the users are saved. So these will be denied. So this is why you can use your maybe you can talk about a file directory you can use for security purpose, that you want to allow or deny some specific files. Okay, after that we want to talk about like custom logs. So you can go here for custom. Okay, so custom log directory is available here. So you can specify that what sort of log you want to have. You can go to internet just to check out the log format. There are multiple log formats are available. So if you want to have like what sort of data you want to capture in your log, so that will be used here. Then after, what is the log level you want to have? Log level, currently it is warning, so it could be set to maybe error, it could be set to critical, or it could be sent to, it could be set to maybe info or maybe debug. So the type of logs you want to get generated via your HTTP service. So this sort of stuff you can configure using your HTTPD service. Okay, so there are multiple more options, but for now I feel myself that these are good enough. And obviously there is one more final left, let me tell you, that is directory index. D, let me write here, directory, directory index. I will tell you what is this. So directory index, If you want to go for directory based hosting, for example, you want to have such kind of fashion in your system or in your operating system or using your web server that your domain name is www.servergyan.com. So you want to have one directory www.servergyan.com/abc, and inside abc you have mentioned this particular index.html. So your URL will be enabled using that particular directory. It means you can go for directory based hosting, but make sure that directory, that particular directory has to be inside your where www html folder only. If that is outside, so you will have to face problems with your service. Okay, so these are some options which are frequently used, or which you should know at least, that how to configure and how to access your service using httpd. So these are basic options I have explained to you. Now I'm going to start the services. I'm going to start service httpd status status. You can run this command. So this currently is redirecting to this particular server. Loaded but disabled, inactive, dead. It means service is not currently running. So when I run this command service httpd status, so this particular sends the output to bin system ctl status http.service. So whatever command you want, you can run. So either you can run that command or you can use system ctl command. So both the commands are going to do the same stuff. Both the commands are going to work in the same manner. I'm going to say restart. So now it will show me status as running. Currently it is running and multiple processes are running with main PID is this processing request. C group is systemd.slice and http.service. Then after these services are running with different PIDs. These are child process, this is parent process. Fine. Now what? If I want to go here slash where www.html, if I go here and I check, there is nothing available. So okay, so vimindexindex.html file I'm going to create here. And now what if I want that I want to create any file here? Maybe if you want to go for html, so you can write one html tag here, html, and after that you can write here, this is my first web server, and after that you can close this tag. I'm not good at HTML writing, so please forgive me if I commit any mistake. So this is my HTML file, and now if I want to check whether my service is enabled properly or not, so I can copy this and I can paste this in different. Okay, so I will have to check whether, okay, this is my first web server. Fine. So this particular request is working properly. It means my web server is enabled and this particular server is working properly, but this is not secure. Reason being, this is working on HTTP. So how to enable HTTPS? I will definitely demonstrate you guys, but within next video, because I know if I go for that particular, so this video is going to be quite lengthy. But for now, I am going to show you that how to configure virtual hosting. Virtual hosting means that you want to run multiple websites using same server or something. So that is known as virtual hosting. So how can you configure that? How do you want to enable that? So I'm going to let you know. So once again, let us go back to our configuration file, which is vim/etc. Vim is our editor, httpd, and with httpd then go to conf, and after conf you need to go to your http.conf, go here. Now search for directory virtual, 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 search here for, and press n for next. So you will find here virtual hosting tab, virtual host. Okay, so you should find here something. If it is not available, we will have to write manually all the entries ourselves, but no issues, we can write here because we know how to configure it and how to do all the things, so we know it. So I think I will have to write it manually here. Fine. So how do we need to enable this? Let me show you here. Go here and start writing your script. Okay, I am at wrong place. I must write down here under this particular section of if module. So your virtual hosting should be enabled at such a place where you are using your site and you are using your particular new module or new directory. So you should not hamper or you should not tamper with your existing module. So what you need to do is you need to enable it here. So let's start writing here. So first of all, we have to write here virtual, V-I-R-T-U-A-L, virtual. Then after host, H-O-S-T, virtual host, you have to write here. Then you have to give the IP address of the server. So I'm going to say local, L-O-C-A-L, local host. Then port number I will have to specify. I'm going to write here 80 because my server is working on port 80 only. Close this. Then after, you have to write document root. So maybe I'm going to write here document document root. I will have to specify document root. Document root I will have to specify here slash where slash www slash html slash lokendra lokendra. I will have to write this. Then after, I will have to give the server name. Server name I will have to give here. Server name will be lokendra dot servergyan dot com. Obviously this will not work on internet, reason being because this domain does not exist. I'm just showing you for example. Then after, if you want to specify server admin, then you can specify your ID. Maybe I'm going to specify here server gyan just a minute, gyan at the rate gmail.com. So whatever email ID you want to specify, you can specify here. After that, if you want to set your error log, if you want to specify your error log here, so you need to specify error log. Then after, you need to specify directory where you want to have logs enabled for this. So within inverted commas, you will have to write here and write here logs. Then after, mention slash, then after E, okay, name of your log file, lokendra dot, maybe you can specify here lokendra underscore accs dot log, and close the bracket. Same here, if you want to go here for access log or you want to go here for custom log, so you can go in the same fashion. Just now close the directory here, virtual virtual host, you can specify here and close the bracket. That is it. So this is how you can go for hosting your virtual hosting, you can go here for. Now copy this and create a directory mkdir and paste in your directory whatever you wanted to create. Now go inside the directory, just run a command cd escape then dot, it means your last command's last argument will be printed. Write a file here vim and then go here for your index.html index index.html index.html file you will create here. Okay, let me type in here index 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 and I'm going to specify something here. This is my virtual virtual hosting. So whatever you want to specify, you can specify here. That does not make much difference here. Reason being, we have to just generate one file as we shall be able to find out here. Service httpd restart, go for restart service, reason being. And if you want that your service would be reloaded, so you can service httpd reload as well. Basic difference is if you restart it, so once your service will be started, when you will restart your service, so first of all your service will go down completely, then your service will come up again. It means all the existing connection will be broken. But if you will go to reload your service, reload means that all the existing connection will be working in the same fashion, all the existing request will be serving in proper manner, and your new changes, whatever you have made in a configuration file, will be reflected as and when you will reload your HTTPD service. Fine. So now how do I need to access my server? So for accessing it, I will have to specify curl command. I can specify curl localhost if you run. So this is my virtual hosting. Reason being, now I have mentioned that on my localhost, because I specified there that on my localhost this particular will be running. And if I check out here, so let us see what output does it give us. So this is my first web server. This is still working in the same fashion. And if I have mentioned here localhost, so this is giving me some different output. It means my virtual hosting is working properly. If I curl localhost, it means that is giving proper output as it is supposed to give. Fine. So now let us talk about some more things here within this particular, that what does it mean, how does it work. So let me explain you. I know this video is a bit lengthy, but definitely you are going to gain good amount of knowledge. Reason being, because if you go to face interview, so many questions are asked from HTTPD service, and you should have proper knowledge because they can ask you such kind of question which I'm going to discuss with you right now. So etc httpd.conf/http.conf. fine. So now let us talk about what does it mean virtual host. Virtual host means this is a block that provides access to document root which is defined down. It means this is a particular document root which you are going to define. So this particular virtual host gives access to this directive, or this directory you can say. Now when you talk about server name means a particular site what you want to access. Then after, if you talk about document root, so that what I already have discussed, where you are going to keep your data. Then after, if you talk about your server admin, this is your email ID where you will be notified in case of any error. If you talk about error log, so this will be directory where your error or maybe your access log, whatever name you want to give. I know I have given something wrong here. This is access log. Ideally, this is supposed to be error log. Okay, then after you can mention here your custom log, you can write here your server alias as well. Now what is server alias? So there can be exactly 0 or 1 server name directories inside virtual host. It means when we are talking about server name, so either this could be there or this could not be there, but this could be multiple host name could be there. If a single virtual host needs to be used for more than one domain name, it means if this particular virtual host has to be used to multiple domain names, then you can use here server alias. Server alias, how do you specify that? Let me mention it here. S-E-R-V-E-R, server A-L-I-A-S, server alias. You can specify here, and XYZ, whatever alias you want to give here, you can give it XYZ dot ServerGyan.com. So this is the alias name of your server name. This is your alias. So this is how you can specify it. This will take effect only after reloading your web server. Okay. Then after, if you talk about location, so you can specify locations here, and after that multiple configuration setting you can do here within this particular configuration file. Now there is one very important thing I would like to mention here. When you are talking about virtual host star localhost.at, so this will run only on localhost. But if you specify your IP address here, or if you specify star here, so that will start working either on your localhost, on your IP address, or if you are going to specify any domain name, so that will start working with everything. Now port 80 will always match the regular HTTP traffic on port 80 TCP. What does it mean? What I mean to say is that whenever any request will come on port 80, so that will be redirected to this particular folder, that will be sent here. Now, effectively disabling the main server configuration from ever being used on traffic on port 80. Now, if you enable here star, so star means everything, what every request, whatever is going to come on this particular this particular port. So everything will be related to this particular. But for now, I have mentioned here localhost, so that is why my both the sites are working properly. Reason being, my port 80 is listening to localhost for my virtual domain, for my virtual hosting, and my IP address for this particular server is listening to my actual domain. Okay, now there are some error codes as well. You must know that what error codes are. So when your server does not respond properly, so you will get somewhere 5XX means either the server is not responding properly. Then after 502 means your web server is not able to connect with your database properly. 503 means there is some other error related to your server. 404 means missing h.html. It means your file does not exist. Whatever file you are trying to access, that does not exist on server. 403, if there is an error log, so it means either your file, whatever you are trying to access, that is out of this context path, or that does not have proper permission. Maybe that file has 400. It means read permission to owner and rest of users do not have read access to that file. So that could be a problem for 403. 402 means obviously whenever your subscription your file does not give you a proper output, so that can provide you 402 error. So there are multiple error codes, whatever you want you can go for. And ideally, whenever you are trying to access your server, so that should ideally return only one code, that is 200. 200 means your files are served properly in proper manner. There is no problem observed. Your site is working properly. Then after, if error code is 301, it means your site is redirecting your request to some other server, because your server is being used as a proxy server. So this is how you can find out. So within next video, obviously I'm going to discuss about this as well, that what does it mean, how does it work, so how to enable all these things. Within next video, obviously I'm going to discuss about HTTPS. It means how to work with your HTTPS, how to secure your server. For example, if you want to see, so this is saying not secure. How you can secure it? So there are two types of certificates available, either self-signed, so we will go and we will try to configure self-signed certificate here. And second type of certificate is known as CA signed. CA means certificate authority signed servers. Maybe GoDaddy and rest of certificate providers are there. So we will try to configure both self-signed as well as CA signed certificate. We will try to configure on our domain, and post that we will try to access our site using HTTPS. Fine. So I think, guys, this is it for this video, because obviously this has been lengthy and you have learned a lot using this video, I hope. So thank you very much for watching. Have a good time. Happy learning from ServerGyan. And please do not forget to like, share and subscribe to my channel. And please do share with your friends, as this will be able to learn new things, new stuff, and this will be able to change their job, and they should be able to get some confidence. Okay, fine. So thank you so very much. Have a good time. Happy learning from ServerGyan. Have a good time.